Welcome. In this lesson, I will discuss 2019 KCSE chemistry paper 1. Here you have a question. The flow chart in figure 1 represents some stages in extraction of copper metal. I use it and answer the questions that follow. So here you have the flow chart, and then here you have questions. Therefore, there is a need to discuss extraction of copper metal. So copper is a metal. What you need to note during extraction of copper, one is definition of an ore, chief ore, extraction process, properties of copper, and finally uses of copper. Now, an ore is a rock which contains the mineral. That is a rock containing mineral. Is a rock containing mineral. A chief ore or main ore. This is an ore from which the metal can be obtained on a commercial scale. Now, the main ore used in extraction of copper is copper pyrite. The chemical name is copper ion disulfide. Other ores include malachite. The chemical name is basic copper carbonate. The other one is copper glance. The chemical name is copper 1 sulfide. Extraction process, extract copper metal. One is a crushing of the ore. Crushing is done to increase surface area for extraction of copper. Two, we have concentration of the ore. Concentration is done mainly to remove impurities. So how is it done? It is done by a process called froth flotation. Now, a question here you can get is describe how froth flotation is done. So froth flotation, this is the process whereby the ore is ground into fine powder, then it's mixed with the water which contains a special oil such as pine. This pine oil acts as a frothing agent. Now, the froth which is rich in the mineral is formed at the top while the impurities sink at the bottom. Then the froth now is skimmed and dried. Now, that process is a reduction of the ore. And the reduction of the ore, it involves three stages. The first stage is called roasting. It occurs in the roasting furnace. What does it involve? Copper pyrite is roasted in a limited supply of air in a large flat furnace. This is to increase surface area. Then it forms copper 1 sulfide, iron 2 oxide, and sulfur 4 oxide. So this is the chemical reaction that occurs in the first roasting furnace. So you have copper pyrite, which is CuFeS2, solid there. And this now is reacted or is roasted in a limited supply of air, that is oxygen here, gas there. Therefore, this one will give you three products. It will give you three products. One, you will get copper 1 sulfide, that is Cu2S there, solid. It will give you iron 2 oxide. It will give you iron 2 oxide there. And then the other one is sulfur 4 oxide. It will give you sulfur 4 oxide gas. So this gas is going to escape. So the environmental pollution of this process is sulfur 4 oxide will form acidic rain, since it's an acidic gas. So how do you balance this equation? How do you balance this equation? So here you have copper here is 2. So here you place copper 2 here. There is 2. Iron here is 2. So iron here you place 2. So iron you place there 2. Oxygen is 4. Here you have 1 here. So here you place 3. There you place 3. So here sulfur is 3 plus 1, that is 4. Oxygen here is 2 here. Plus 6, that is 8. So here you place 4 there. And there you place 4. So that equation is balanced. Now, in the second stage of the reduction, you have smelting, which occurs in the smelting furnace. So what will happen is that silicon 4 oxide is added to the mixture of copper 1 sulfide and iron 2 oxide. And this one now is heated in the absence of air. So the silicon 4 oxide reacts with the iron 2 oxide. Because silicon 4 oxide will act as an acidic oxide, while iron 2 oxide is a basic oxide. Therefore, that now will lead to a formation of iron 2 silicate, which separates out as it's lack a living copper one sulfide. So because there is iron 2 oxide, so you have iron 2 oxide there solid, it will react with the silicon 4 oxide solid there. This will now lead to a product called slag, that is a iron 2 silicate, that is a FeSiO3. This one is a liquid, the state molten. So this iron 2 silicate, the common name is slag, so it will be separated out, it will be removed out of the system. So that one will leave copper 1 sulfide, it will leave copper 1 sulfide. So the next step, that is another third step, the copper 1 sulfide is taken to the second roasting furnace, whereby copper 1 sulfide is heated in a regulated supply of air, where some of it is converted to copper 1 oxide. So you have copper 1 sulfide, that is solid. It is heated in air, that is oxygen gas there. Therefore, this one I will give you a copper 1 oxide, that is Cu2O there. Copper 1 oxide plus an acidic gas, which is sulfur 4 oxide, there. So to balance this equation, here you have copper 2, here. Sulfur here is 1, sulfur here is 1, oxygen here is 2, oxygen here is 3. So how do you balance this? So you place here 2, copper there is 4, here you place 2, copper there is 4. Oxygen here is, sulfur here is 2, sulfur here you place 2 there. So oxygen here is 6 there, so here you place 3. So oxygen here is 2, 2 plus 4, that is 6, and then here you have 6 there. Then from there now, what will happen is that this copper 1 oxide formed, it will react with the remaining copper 1 sulfide. So it, the assumption is that not all copper 1 sulfide will be roasted here. So some of it will remain, and therefore the remaining amount will react with the copper 1 oxide. So this is how the reaction occurs. So you will have the remaining copper 1 sulfide. It will react with the copper 1 oxide formed in the second roasting furnace. Therefore, this one I will deposit copper. So there, plus sulfur 4 oxide there. This is a gas, acidic gas again. So that's another equation that occurs there. So to balance this equation, here you have copper 2, here copper 2, sulfur here is 1, sulfur here is 1, oxygen here is 1, oxygen here is 2. So here you place 2 here. So copper here becomes 4 here plus 2, that is 6. Here you place 6 here. Here you place 6 there. There you place 6. So sulfur here is 1. Oxygen here is 2. Oxygen there is 2. So that equation is balanced. Now this copper which is obtained is called blister copper. The reason for this is when a liquid copper which is formed is allowed to cool, it will solidify, releasing bubbles of sulfur 4 oxide gas, which gives it a blister appearance, hence called a blister copper. Note that the blister copper obtained is about 97%, and therefore it is used to make boilers and pipes only. So that blister copper cannot be used in the making of electrical cables. Therefore, now that copper now which is obtained is impure. So how do you make it appear? So you do it purification by use of electrolysis. You do purification by use of electrolysis. So that's now the fourth process. Remember, the first process was crushing. The second one was concentration, and then the third one was reduction. However, under reduction we had fast roasting, we had smelting, and then lastly we have second roasting, and then the fourth process now, which is the last process, is a purification of copper. So how is it done? This is the setup for electrolysis of impure copper. So generally what you need to notice is that when you want to purify impure substance or impure element, then the anode should be the impure. The anode should be the impure. So the trick here is that anode should be impure. Anode should be impure. That's Mn. Mn alphabetical. Mn. So the anode, you make it the impure substance. While the cathode, you make it the pure. The cathode becomes the pure substance. So for this case, this electrolysis setup, where do you have the impure? Where do you have the anode? So this is the anode. When we are representing an anode, anode should be long, thin. Then this is the cathode, short and thick. Therefore, this is the anode. So, and the anode is what? Is impure. The anode is impure copper. The anode is impure copper. The anode is impure copper. Then this short and thick line represents the cathode. And the cathode is what? Is pure copper. The cathode is pure copper. So this is pure copper, becomes the cathode. Then the electrolyte here, or the salt, should be that of copper 2 ions. It should be that of copper 2 ions. It can be copper sulfate, or copper nitrate, and so on. So how does the reaction occur here? The reaction that occurs at the anode is copper oxidation will occur there. Copper atoms will lose electrons to form copper 2 ions, aqueous there, plus 2 electrons there. So this is the reaction that occurs at the anode. And then the reaction that occurs at the cathode is copper ions, aqueous there. It will gain the number of electrons that are lost at the anode, which is 2 electrons here. So this one I will give you a copper solid. It will deposit copper solid. It will deposit copper solid. So after the electrolysis process, what will happen is that here a substance will be formed here called a sediment. Sediment, that's another remaining. It's called a sediment. So that's now a note that after purification, still there will be some traces of gold and silver, which will be collected as sludge at the bottom of the electrolytic cell. That is, this sediment that is collected here, it will contain some traces of gold and silver. Purification of copper is done. How the flow chart of extraction of copper looks like. So here you have the main ore, that's copper pyrite. Here you have the fast roasting furnace. Remember here what happens, we're talking about. This copper pyrite will be roasted in air. It will be roasted in air. So a reaction that occurs here is copper pyrite plus oxygen gas. It will give you three products. One sulfur oxide, it will escape. You have copper 1 sulfide, and then you have iron 2 oxide. So both of these, it is pumped into the smelting furnace. Into the smelting furnace, whereby in the smelting furnace, silicon 4 oxide is pumped in. So silicon 4 oxide will react with iron 2 oxide to form iron 2 silicate, which becomes a slag. Hence, it is separated out. Then the remaining copper 1 sulfide goes to the second roasting furnace, whereby here copper 1 sulfide will be roasted in a limited supply of air, that's in oxygen. It will form copper 1 oxide plus sulfur 4 oxide. So sulfur 4 oxide escapes. Now that copper 1 oxide formed, it will again react with the remaining copper 1 sulfide to form a blister copper. And that blister copper, since it is impure, electrolysis will be done. And therefore, finally, pure copper is obtained. Copper can also be obtained from copper 2 carbonate by, first of all, roasting. So you roast copper 2 carbonate, and this is how the roasting equation occurs. So here you have copper 2 carbonate, that is CO3 there. So you roast this one. So when you roast now, this metal carbonate, you will get a corresponding metal oxide. That is, you will get copper 2 oxide, solid there, plus carbon 4 oxide here, gas there. Education balance, so what we require contains in copper 2 oxide. Therefore, you take this copper 2 oxide, and then you react with the reducing agent. So the reducing agent that you can use here is either a coke that is a carbon or carbon dioxide. So here, if you react with the coke, which is a carbon, remember now carbon is a reducing agent, therefore it will reduce this and it will give you a copper metal here plus carbon dioxide. Plus carbon dioxide gas there. Or in case if we use copper dioxide as a reducing agent, I mean if we use carbon dioxide as a reducing agent, then the reaction will occur as follows. That is copper dioxide plus carbon dioxide, this gas. Therefore, this one now it will deposit copper plus carbon dioxide, plus carbon dioxide there. So to balance this equation, here you have two oxygen, so here you place two, here you place two. So two oxygen there, two copper here, one carbon there. So that's now another way copper can be obtained from copper to a carbonate. Now, physical properties of copper. One, it has a high melting and boiling point. This is due to a strong metallic bond. It's a good conductor of heat and electricity due to presence of delocalized electrons. Three, it is ductile. Four, it is malleable. Then you have the chemical properties of copper. Generally, remember copper is less reactive, hence it does not react with water and steam. It does not react with dilute acids, but a reaction of copper with chlorine gas can only occur when there is a condition of heat to form copper 2 chloride, which is green. Now, if note that copper burns with a blue flame in air to form a black solid of copper 2 oxide. Finally, we have uses of copper. It's used in making of electrical wires, contacting switches, plugs, and sockets. This is because copper is a good conductor of electricity. It's used in making of alloys such as brass. Brass is an alloy of copper and zinc. It's also used in making of bronze. Bronze is an alloy of copper and tin. Copper is also used in making of coin and ornaments. It's also used in making soldering instruments due to high thermal conductivity. Let us answer another question. Study the flow chart. So here we have copper ore. That's now copper pyrite. Crushing is done. You have fine powder. The reason for crushing, we said, is to increase surface area for extraction process. Then you have fine powder here. Process B, concentrated copper ore. So this is a froth flotation. This is froth flotation. The aim for that is to remove impurities. Then that copper is roasted in air to obtain three products here. That is copper 1 sulfide, iron 2 oxide, and sulfur 4 oxide. So here silicon 4 oxide is pumped in here. So silicon 4 oxide, it will only react with iron 2 oxide here. It will form slag. So the chemical name of slag is iron 2 silicate. Then from there here, this copper 1 sulfide, it will be roasted further in air to form copper 1 oxide. So that copper 1 oxide now, it will react with the remaining copper 1 sulfide to form copper. Remember this solid, so the copper over here is a copper pyrite. It is a copper pyrite. The symbol is Cu Fe S2 there. Then identify process B. Process B is a froth flotation. Then identify solid C. Solid C here is copper. Solid C here is copper. Learners note that in an exam, if you are to identify, you have the option to write the symbol or the name. Here you can write copper pyrite, or here you can write copper. But if you are told name, in naming you cannot write the symbol of the substance. You must write the full name. Then you have to write an equation for the reaction that forms the slag. So slag is iron 2 oxide. It is iron 2 oxide solid. It will react with the silicon 4 oxide. That is SiO2 there. That is solid. Therefore, this one I will give you a slag. That is iron 2 silicate. It will give you iron 2 silicate. That is Fe SiO3 there. That's a molten. So that's how the reaction occurs. Thank you.